One of my greatest regrets is that I've never travelled, but I love looking at the world in Google Maps, exploring the globe from its brightest cities to its darkest untravelled hideaways. Microsoft Flight Simulator is kind of the same, except you're in a virtual plane, and instead of Google Maps you've got Bing. The world looks amazing, well, you're a few thousand feet above it at least, but once you get down to ground level, you see the tricks and compromises that allow the game to give you an entire planet to mess around with. Of course, if you're getting that close, your credentials as a pilot should be seriously called into question. Some places, the ones that have essentially been handcrafted, look great. Others, the ones generated by soulless algorithms, aren't so hot. Melbourne, the city of my birth, is almost unrecognisable. To be fair, it also looks pretty crap on Bing Maps, which is a real shame because on Google Maps it's had high-fidelity 3D models for quite a few years now. The weather effects, though, are a real highlight. The storms look fantastic, and it's fun to play God and bring thunderbolts and lightning down on a city whose football team you don't like, or basketball team, or kabaddi team, or whatever your regional sports ball of preference is. Actually, I don't think kabaddi has a ball. Whatever. Of course, the main draw of the game is realistic flying physics, probably. I have no idea. I really do just play the game to zoom around looking at pretty places I might like to visit one day, but almost certainly never will. And honestly, Google Maps is a cheaper option, and one that doesn't require a supercomputer to run.